Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Brian Pretti, Chief Investment Officer at Capital Planning Advisors, joins us today. And Brian, when we last spoke to you, you had mentioned that one of your main worries was a wholesale loss of confidence by investors in central bank and monetary policy. Now that we have seen the Fed raise rates this week, albeit very slightly, because we're speaking on Friday the 18th, it's been the first time in 10 years that they've done so, and we've been at the zero bound for around 7 years. The question I have for you, Brian, is have you seen anything that's taken place, at least in the bond market or elsewhere, that has raised your concern that we might be seeing the shift in confidence by investors toward central banks and the effectiveness of monetary policy?
You know, Chris, one of the things I've been looking for a while is that kind of break in confidence. I think part of what really underpinned the bull market over the last X years, you know, was not only a lot of money printing, that's a pretty good underpinning, but also that sense of, well, you know what, the Fed's going to do whatever it takes. It's almost right out of Mario Draghi's mouth. You know, we will do whatever it takes to make all this stuff right. Well, the big question is, number one, do you know the right solution and, you know, do you know whatever it takes? And secondly is, can you really, really, really affect that? Or is it going to be, you know, the fundamental world of not only the markets and the economy not allowing you to perhaps get to the quote-unquote promised land, if you will? We know right now, bond dealer inventories are at one of the lowest levels we've seen in a long, 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 long time. And I get it. You know, in this environment, what major wirehouse wants to have a huge inventory of bonds? And the answer is nobody. No way. So, you know, in essence, at least for the huge wirehouses, unless they're going to match you on the other side of the trade with somebody else, it's going to be a tougher time getting things done on the bond side, on the fixed income side, than we've seen in other market environments. So it's just a little bit of a different fingerprint character point. And we already know that Dodd-Frank, too, you know, has dropped, if you will, the liquidity levels that we would have been used to in prior market cycles with a number of the big banks, investment banks that are out there, too, in this cycle. So, you know, if anything, Chris, I would argue that stop looking and anticipating these wonderful quarter point deals. That's nothing. The real key is the balance sheet, and the real key is market liquidity and what that means. And maybe at the outskirts of town, Chris, and again, not that this should have been unanticipated, we've seen some relatively meaningful emotional, if nothing else, deterioration in the high yield markets as of late. And it's not that they haven't been deteriorating now for some time. They just accelerated to the downside. We've seen that crossover a little bit into investment grade. We've seen it crossover into bank loans. And again, you know, when credit cycles start to change, even at the margin, it raises people's emotional quotient, if you will, and they get scared. You know, I get it. And especially at these really, really low, if you will, yield levels, because boy, Chris, it doesn't take too much of a change in price to wipe out those coupons in about 5 seconds. So maybe the real keys as we look forward is liquidity, Fed, liquidity, markets, liquidity in this cycle that's very, very different than prior cycles.
Well, it's very interesting that you said that the key things to look at here are the Fed's balance sheet and liquidity, because that was actually a comment that was made by Felix Zuloff when we spoke to him recently, in that he thought that for the Fed to maintain this target range of 25 to 50 basis points, so a quarter to half a point, that they would actually have to drain reserves off their balance sheet more than what they even expect, what the Fed expects, and certainly more than the market would expect. And that he thought that this would actually end up leading to a contraction of liquidity and perhaps another drawdown. He was citing that he's forecasting another down leg in the market sometime either early part of next year, maybe around January, February, or thereabouts. And it would largely be tied to this question around liquidity. And we've had a number of other people that have said this as well. I believe Jeff Gundlach has made comments about the Fed shouldn't be hiking rates given the problems that we're seeing in the high yield market and some other issues. So there's definitely some people out there who are seeing risks, even with this very small quarter point increase. But like you say, it's largely tied to the larger forces of global liquidity and the size of their balance sheet, which is, I mean, if we look, it's been highly correlated to the stock market ever since about 2009.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.